Pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. On this day within our Blessed Lady's Assumption octave, we keep the feast day of one of her great servants, St. Hyacinth. And we commemorate as well the octave, or the eighth day, of the feast of one of the great martyrs of the Roman Church, to whose church we so often go in spirit throughout the year, St. Lawrence. Amongst his many patronages, St. Lawrence is invoked, if I'm not mistaken, as one of the patron saints of cooks. And that shows a little bit everybody's sense of humor, that we mustn't take these things too terribly seriously. Nor did he, remember, because he would not hand over the treasures of the church, the sacred vessels and the books in particular, to Diocletian in the last and the greatest of the persecutions, he being the deacon who was charged with the care of these things, as well as the poor. He showed Diocletian the soldiers, his officers, the poor, the widows, and the sick, and said, these are the true treasures of the church. And for his pains, he was slowly barbecued or grilled to death. And you know that when you're cooking, timing is everything. That's why I've never quite been able to master the art of cooking or getting an entire meal together, because you have to have everything timed, don't you? Well, St. Lawrence looks up from the grill at a certain point and says, Asatum etiam verset manduka. While I'm broiled on this side, turn me over and serve me up. Well, I don't imagine that they were anything but very, very surprised to hear this saint in the excruciating agony, still to be able to make a little joke. Well, in due time, his soul was ready, and it fled up to heaven, and he died as a great martyr of the church. I think of him in connection with St. Hyacinth, because St. Hyacinth is an unusual example of a saint who was ready before his time. So his baking time, as it were, would maybe even cut in half. He has the unusual distinction of being one of the few religious who have ever been admitted into the Dominican or any order who is dispensed of making the canonical one-year trial period called the novitiate. He was already an educated man and a canon of the church in Krakow in Poland when he went with his uncle and his brother, his uncle, the new bishop of Krakow, to pay his honor to the seat of the Prince of the Apostles in Rome. There they met and were enchanted with Dominic Guzman, our Saint Dominic, so much so that both Saint Hyacinth and his brother were filled with a holy desire to become Dominicans and then to become missionaries, because the bishop had asked that missionaries be sent, because he said there are many places in Poland and North where there were still pagans who needed to be converted to Christianity and baptized. So St. Hyacinth was given the holy habit by St. Dominic himself and made a novitiate of only 6 months rather than the year. He was done early. But then he became one of the greatest of the Dominicans and one of the greatest of preachers. He is known as the Apostle of the North. They say he went as far to the west as Scotland. He certainly went through Scandinavia. He went down into Russia, Ukraine, what is today Ukraine, and to the Slavic lands. He went everywhere, establishing the Dominican order and converting the pagans to Christianity and firming up the Catholics in their holy faith. After such a long and an exhausting apostolate, towards the end, Our Lady gave him a wonderful grace, which has its own lesson too. You know how very often it is that in our life, we consider that doing this or that thing would just be one thing too many. That would just be too much. And I imagine many people look wistfully at their rosary beads at night and say, well, not tonight, Blessed Mother, I'm just too tired. It would be too heavy a burden to put that in too. Well, St. Hyacinth, when apprised of the fact that the Tartars had invaded the city on the Vistula River, where he had established a Dominican priory and church, took the Blessed Sacrament with him from the altar and gathered his brethren around him, and they were going to leave everything, seek safety, take our Lord with them. As he was passing by the Blessed Mother's altar, Our Lady called out to him, and she said, are you leaving me behind? And St. Hyacinth felt very bad about it, because he loved Our Lady very much. So So he goes up to the altar and he gets the altar. Big statue in alabaster, very, very heavy, of the Blessed Mother. And he picked it up and it was light as a feather. And he carries the Blessed Mother in one hand and our Blessed Lord in the ciborium in the other. And with his brethren around him, they go out and the Vistula River, they cross over. That was the first time that he had walked over water like Moses. And then he gets to the other side, and very, very quickly, almost miraculously, they're taken to the nearest Dominican church where he deposits his treasures, our Blessed Lady and our Lord. Let us ask St. Hyacinth, the saint who was ready early, to make us maybe sometimes anticipate early some of our prayers and devotions so we don't let them aside because of the weakness of the flesh or any other cause, and never, ever in our lives to consider that the Blessed Mother is one thing too many, that she would be a heavy burden to serve her, because it's the lightest and the most joyful thing of all for us to serve Mary. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Now we continue our novena for the Assumption.